Yeah, they're nothing to do with my weekend activities.
The reason I got this ring, I got invited to this fancy dress party this girl I haven't seen for ages. You know, a good mate of mine, they left it really last minute for fancy dress. And this was all there was left in the fancy dress shop. Turned up in it, no one found it funny, and they haven't seen the girl since.
He may sweat like a bitch, but don't forget he's still fitter than us. He's still a trained lieutenant in the Royal Marines, so he'd still piss all over
Lieutenant
us.
Rogers,
yeah. How old is he?
How old is he?
Is he 21? My brother is older than him.
I'm 20.
He's the same age as me.
He's a big bastard,
and he's fucking nails, isn't he? He is nails. The arms on that fella. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me.
Combination of 9 months training, blood, sweat and tears for every one of you. Only 8 hours now stands between you and getting a green beret. Tell yourself if you feel you cannot go on that you will take one small step more. For in truth and in honesty, the largest of feats are completed by the smallest of steps added together, repeated. This is the last hurdle. Let's see it happen. 30 miles, 8 hours. You all up for it?
Sir. Sir.
I'll see each and every one of you at the end. Good luck, men.
4, 3, 2, 1,
where you go? Good luck, man. Okay. Row, row, row. Rowing down the river. Step,
step, step, step, step, step out into the sea. There he is, Dave.
Tell you what, mate, it's weird, isn't it, that a little bird can cause so much interest.
Every time I see him, it's like, oh, Dave! And it's like this excitement that our one friend of the sea has come back to see us again and again.
What are you doing, Orlando?
I'm shitting!
But there were visitors, and there were visitors.
Ben just saw a little shark. We've named the shark Percival. Percy for short.
Yeah, Percy, Percy, Percy. Yeah,
Percy, Percy. Shit the fucking bed, man.
Come on, come pick up your cake. Get over there now.
I'm spent.
Well, crikey. Before I joined the Royal Marines, I was, well, actually, I was a reprobate. I was a bit of a problem child, too hyperactive. And then one time on Dartmoor, Cliff, this is a good one, I wasn't allowed to go horse riding. So I ran away from my mum across Dartmoor, hid behind a rock. National park wardens came to look for me, police came to look for me, and then all of a sudden, as I was camouflaged behind this rock, a police helicopter came over the horizon and started hunting for me. I ran away on Dartmoor, and that was me in foster care and off to boarding school.
Go!
And then a social worker said, right, you need to do something with your life. Joined the Royal Marine Reserves when I was 16 years old, as early as I could, and then joined the Marines straight after that. So it's been a focus, really, for my energy. And I think too often people dismiss problem children is going nowhere and doing nothing with their lives, and I think in my case it's probably just misdirected energy.
Two hours on, two hours off. Row, eat, sleep. Row, eat, sleep.
I spy with my little eye something beginning with W.
It's raining very, very heavily. And you know why I'm laughing? Because I'm the only person in the cabin, which means that Ben is on the oars. I'm warm and I'm dry and I'm in bed. Ben's got 2 hours on the oars in the rain.
There we are, cheerfulness in the face of your best mate's adversity. Does that count?
Many things I've learned from this trip.
patience, blah, 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 blah. And the final thing I've learned is that I will never, ever have a six-pack. Genetically, it is impossible for me to get a six-pack. However hard I diet, however hard I feast, however much fizz I do, I will not have a six-pack.
The finishing line was an invisible one, but there was no mistaking when we crossed it. All the day.